Hello and welcome to Driving with Todd, and I'm Todd. The Rolling Stones. Love the Rolling Stones, one of my favorite bands. They're in my top five list of favorite groups. They released a string of psychedelic songs starting with Painted Black in May of 1966. Followed that up with Mother's Little Helper. And then Have You Seen Your Mother, Baby, Standing in the Shadows. And in January of 1967 came out Ruby Tuesday. After that, We Love You. After that, In Another Land. Then She's a Rainbow. And last, 2000 Light Years from Home. Now you might say they're not all psychedelic songs, but they all had that flavor. There was a change in the Rolling Stones starting with Painted Black. Their music and their sound was changing. It was maturing. And with 1967 having five singles released, and all in a whole totally new vein, similar to psychedelic music, they were a different band than what they were early on when they were doing rock and blues. In December 1967, they also released an album called Their Satanic Majesty's Request, which again was flavored to be a psychedelic album. Very avant-garde, a lot of different sounds and instruments used on that album. It's just a totally change from Between the Buttons, which was their previous album. I actually bought their Satanic Majesty's Request in the summer of 1968. And I took it home, and I gotta say, I didn't like the whole album. There were songs on there, I'm going, wow, they're kind of like just going on and on. You can stop any time now. But there was so many great songs on it that I played it often to the point where this whole album is one of my favorite Rolling Stones albums today. I have many, many, many copies of it. I've got lots of bootlegs. I've got a couple box sets of bootlegs of outtakes, outtake sessions and backing tracks and whatever, other alternate mixes, whatever. But I love the album. I mean, it was panned at the time. Now it's being looked at a lot differently, saying, you know, this was a kind of a new style of music. But they soon went away from it and went to Beggar's Banquet, which was more of their blues, country, rock style. But during that period, the one song that just blew me away, just loved the song, was Ruby Tuesday. It was a great song. It was released as a B-side to the single Let's Spend the Night Together in the United States. Well, what happened was Let's Spend the Night Together was a little too sexual for radio, AM radio, in the United States. So the disc jockeys would flip the record over and play Ruby Tuesday. It was got to be so popular that Ruby Tuesday was their fourth number one hit single on Billboard's Top 100 in the United States. That was quite the achievement for initially being the B-side of a single. So I thought it'd be fun to listen to Ruby Tuesday. I love the song. It's one of those songs that I can play over and over and over and not get sick of it. I just love the melody. The melody's beautiful. It was mostly written by Keith Richards about his girlfriend at the time. And Brian Jones filled in some of the instrumentation pieces where it was like, okay, we need to add these notes to the song and so on. In fact, Brian Jones plays harpsichord on this and recorder, which is kind of cool because, you know, his start was guitar and he got into a lot of different styles and different types of instruments. So here we go with the Rolling Stones doing Ruby Tuesday.
She would never say where she came from. Yesterday don't matter if it's gone. While the sun is bright or in the darkest night, no one knows.
Just stop it there for 2 minutes or less than 2 minutes. They played a double bass in here, and you can see Bill Wyman off the side playing a double bass. They said what happened was it was played both by Keith Richards and Bill Wyman, Bill Wyman was doing the chording on I don't know if it's called a fretboard on a bass like that, and Keith Richards was playing the bow. And then, as you can see, Brian Jones was playing the recorder. So again, very different style of instrumentation for this song. They really made a change from Have You Seen Your Mother, Baby to Ruby Tuesday, with a whole different style of music and different use of different instruments. Pretty cool. It's pretty cool. We're going to go back.
In the darkest night, no one knows. She comes and goes. Why she needs to be so free. She'll tell you it's the only way to be. She just can't be chained to a life where nothing's gained or nothing's lost. At such a cost. There's no time to lose, I heard her say. Catch your dreams before they slip away. Dying all the time, lose your dreams and you may lose your mind. Ain't life unkind?
The other thing about this song too, I mean, very sparse instrumentation, but the drums, there's really limited use of Bill Wyman's drums in this song. It's only like on the refrain that he comes in with the drums, and it's powerful. I mean, it I think what it does, it's like you're kind of going along with the sound, because it's just a very nice melody. There's not a lot of instrumentation, and the instrumentation is all mostly acoustic instruments. And then all of a sudden, these drums come in and just kind of like, whoa, I wasn't expecting that. So that's kind of cool, too. But a great song. And the way they're dressing, I mean, they changed their style of dressing as well, as more of the mod UK psychedelic scene with the different style of clothing that they're wearing. And Brian Jones has that funky white hat on and so on. Just really great presentation and just a dynamite song. I love Ruby Tuesday. Definitely one of my favorite Rolling Stones songs from the 60s. So if you like the Rolling Stones, you like Ruby Tuesday, hit that like button. That'd be really cool. If you have any comments about the Stones, the song Ruby Tuesday, put it in the comments below. That'd be awesome. And if you haven't done so, subscribe to my channel. Just do it right now. Subscribe. And then if you ring the bell, you'll get updates to my latest videos. So I'm hoping Ruby Tuesday is making your day a wonderful Tuesday as well, because it is Tuesday today, so it's a Ruby Tuesday, and I'm hoping you have a smile on your face. And peace out, baby.